One of the core principles behind the design of the internet was that users from everywhere should get the same experience. Censored Planet is the first global internet censorship observatory that collects data continuously from more than 170 countries without end users' participation. The reason why I'm interested to monitor and bring transparency and accountability to this phenomenon is because I strongly believe it takes away opportunity and it degrades human dignity for many who experience it. The technology behind internet censorship is becoming cheaper and cheaper. So it's very affordable for governments, states, you name it, to just buy this and deploy it. There are three common ways that the governments block content. One is by blocking the IP address. There is also DNS poisoning, where the DNS query is going to be poisoned or redirected to where the content is not there. And the third kind is application layer blocking or keyword blocking, where the sensor monitors the traffic and then notice there is a sensitive keyword that is being communicated. As a result of that, it's blocked or it's actually show the user a block page where it said this content is not legal. So Censored Planet capture all these three kinds of monitoring techniques. I grew up with internet being censored, either by university, by government, or more importantly, even servers who provide the information. More and more, I realized that internet censorship should be put into global perspective. It's not just Iran, just China. Trying to have a control on what people or citizens of one country can see is a mission of all the governments. It's just what they care about and what they might want to block. What I think is important is having a transparency on the process. Who is deciding to block what, and do we have a trust on those people for those decisions they're making?